buddy Rick here with another great tip. I have a snake, you know, for clearing drains that I can chuck into a drill, but all of my cordless drills right now are down because the batteries are dead on them, and I always have a cordless corded drill around just for those purposes because, you know, you can't beat the power of a corded drill. But to chuck this into a snake, you can't, that's way too fast. You can't, and I don't think we're talented enough to hold the trigger in one spot and keep it steady, you know. So I thought, well, how can I make this run at a lower speed and you don't have to worry about controlling the trigger? And I thought, well, the trigger here is just a hollow plastic piece of, you know, trigger. And there's nothing inside there, so I just drilled some holes in it. You can see my test holes, and then the first one wasn't far enough, and then the second one I did, it was too far, so I did another one here, and it was perfect. I drilled that out enough to get a small cotter pin through there. You stick the cotter pin through the hole, and then that way you can run the drill at a constant speed, and don't worry about the trigger. And that's about the perfect speed to run a snake. So I just thought I'd share that with you. And the nice thing is you got plenty of room here. You can make different, make it at different speeds. Like this other one I did, it goes a little faster. But it's not 100%. So, if you need to run your drill at a slower, constant speed, try this. Anyway, I hope that helps. Hope you like it. But taught you something you could use. If you like what you see, go ahead and subscribe and come back every week and see what they do next. Until then, hope to see you soon.